The Hunt by Oscar de Muriel, read by Andy Secombe. A hard blizzard hit the forest of Dean on Christmas Eve. It was nothing compared to the disastrous storms that would come in the following weeks, but strong enough to clean the air and the skies. By dawn, there were golden streams of sun trickling in between the leafless trunks of oaks and birches. Deer stalking on Christmas Day was a Frey family tradition, and some of the happiest moments of my childhood took place in those woods. Along with the excitement of the sport, those were the times when my uncle and I became true comrades. Uncle Maurice is my late mother's younger brother, and the perfect balance between English refinement and French candour. The latter is something my father and stepmother still find difficult to tolerate. Fond of the ladies, the drink, and the good times, Uncle Maurice never married or settled down. To him, life is an eternal succession of dinner parties, hunts, and trips. No wonder he's always in such high spirits. That morning, he was the first to rise, even before the servants, and walked into our bedrooms to give us all a good shake. After a wholesome breakfast, my father, my brother Elgi, Uncle Maurice, and I took to our mounts. As Oliver, my flimsiest brother, has never liked anything that involves leaving the house, or moving any limbs at all, he stayed in bed. My eldest brother, whose presence I'd feared all along since the engagement, was fortunately not expected. We all gathered in a small clearing before the hunt began. Men, dogs, and horses projected steamy breaths as we waited for Uncle's foreman to announce that the stags were ready. Uncle Maurice selected the old or infirm animals for stalking, while the healthier specimens were secluded in a reservation where they couldn't be touched. That is how the herds have been kept in good health for centuries, making room for the younger animals and keeping disease at bay. Over a concert of stomping hooves, barking, neighing, and the cracking of whips, my dear uncle chatted earnestly to everyone and everything around him. He turned to my father and shamelessly mocked his appearance. Our poor patriarch, no longer used to such exertion, was wrapped in his thickest jacket, hat, and leather gloves, his face swathed in a woolen scarf that only left his eyes uncovered. Instead of replying, he stared daggers at his brother-in-law, produced his silver hip flask, and pulled down his scarf just enough to have a long swig of brandy.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.